The task force was composed of the different intelligence units of the armed forces. We have an ISAP component, we have an ISF component, ISG component, and the Air Force component. And we are reporting directly to the Chief of Staff and to the Secretary of National Defense on a weekly basis.
And weekly
basis, yes. And we have a lot of areas to cover because there are so many wild information. So nagkaroon ng tasking yung mga different components. Some are operating in Region 3, some are operating in the Visayas, some are in Mindanao, in order to pursue all the leads. But this is always in coordination with other law enforcement agencies, particularly the NBI and the CIDG. So there are many attempts that were made in the past together with NBI, but we failed. And finally, there was a breakthrough with the splendid effort of our NISF component, the Naval Intelligence and Security Force. And natunto nito ang isang bahay dito sa Santa Mesa, wherein we got a report that General Palparan was staying there for almost already more than 3 months. But of course, dahil wala namang visual, so we cannot say that it is already a breakthrough until early hour this morning when our NISF operatives together with NBI were able to have a glimpse of General Palparan, and then they served the warrant in the house of certain Grace Rowa. And Grace Rowa.
Grace Rowa.
Rowa, yes. So the warrant was served, and General Palparan really did not resist the arrest. In fact, he was joking with our operatives, and he was saying, ang gagaling nyo, naisahan nyo ako, kasi medyo naging very lax ako. In a way, this is a good opportunity also for General Palparan to be able to defend himself in court and at the same time attend to some of his health concerns, because he has been suffering from various illness. So this is the time for him to be able to have a good, proper medical checkup.
So may we know specifically ano pong illness ito
siya? What I learned is he has some heart problem. And then he's also diabetic, and mataas yung blood pressure.
Sir, na-establish ba kung ano yung relasyon ni Grace Rowa kay Palparan? Kay General Palparan?
Based on our research made by the NISF, they are long-time family friends.
Family friends.
Way back years, many years
so
ago.
So pwede kasuhan si Grace Rowa?
Obstruction of justice.
Saka cuddling.
I think the NBI will be able to answer that question. I think they can use some other laws to apply.
Was he alone, sir? Or sino po yung mga kasama ni General Palparan na arrested?
He was alone in the house. Mayroong mga nakatirang civilian doon na mga nagrerenta, but they are not in any way connected to General Palparan.
So what's the truth? Was he arrested inside the house or nanguli siya habang nag-withdraw
sa ATM?
Sa ATM.
He was arrested inside the house.
Hindi sa ATM.
He was seen withdrawing money in the ATM.
After noon, sir, umalis sa bahay.
Yeah, it was the time na na-confirm na it was General Palparan.
Saan po Santa Mesa, sir? Ito ba yun sa Teresa?
Oo. Galing kaya ata,
General.
3 months na po siya doon na nakatera.
Based on the information gathered, more than 3 months na siya doon nakikita. I mean, napapansin na mayroong taong nakatira doon na hindi lumalabas ng bahay.
General, have you...
ETF, sir? Anong bangko, sir?
I'm not particular doon, sir.
General, have you...
But,
BPI?
I think BPI, kasi yun yung mga previous data na...
General, have you received information that some military men are helping Palparan
hide from authorities?
He has many friends in the military because he was a very good officer when he was in the service. But nobody from the AAP is scandaling him.
But are they active or retired,
retired
military
officers?
Friends?
Some of his friends are still active, yung mga nag-serve under him.
So those active help him
evade authorities? No one cuddled Gerald Palparan in the active service.
But the retired?
Yung retired, sir.
Retired,
yeah. I don't think so also because from the time na naging fugitive si Gerald Palparan, he cut his communications with his colleagues.
Okay.
In fact, he seldom use cell phone. Okay.
So we can categorically say that Palparan did not receive help from military, active military men while he was hiding from authorities.
Yes, I think I can say that.
General, may patong po ba sa ulo si General?
Yes, 2 million pesos.
So, this is a joint effort. Meron ba mga civilian informant tayong mabibigyan?
Yung informant ng NISF ang makakatanggap
ng NISF. Sir, anong custody? Sino mag, although it's a joint effort again, NBI, bawa AFP mag, ng custody ng Palparan?
It would depend on the court, Malolos court, yung nag-hear ng case.
Pero for the meantime, yung custody sa NBI?
Yes, for the meantime, NBI.
Kaya sino mas mahirap hanapin? Yung mga chamsol o si Gerald Palparan?
Parehas lang mahirap hanapin sila kasi nagtatago eh. Pero mas magaling yung mga operatives natin kasi nakita sila eh.
Sir, you mentioned kanina there were many attempts but it failed. Can you give us a detail? Paano yun? Nakita na siya, nakatakbo, nakita na siya, biglang nawala. Paano po, sir?
Yeah, may mga information before na nagtago sa isang farm.
Okay.
Actually, ni-raid ng NBI yun but it turned out negative.
Is it in Davao, sir?
No, in Central Luzon.
Sir, Bataan, Zambales, and Bulacan, doon lang daw po.
Yes. There are also cases where he was in Zambales and in Bataan.
Okay.
But bago makarating yung mga operatives natin doon, nakaalis na rin siya.
Sir, nakausap na rin na si Javo?
Yes, nakausap kami. Kinumusta ko siya, sabi niya. This morning, yung pagkahuli. Kinausap ko siya. Chine ko kung okay siya. Sabi niya, he's okay. He even congratulated me. Sabi ko, no sir, it's not about that. It's looking at your situation now. And sabi naman niya, nagpapasalamat na rin siya at nahuli siya. Now, he can have a proper medical checkup and he can have his day in court.
General, were you under General Palparan during your younger years?
No, I was not assigned under him. But we have some instances that we work together in some conferences, in some meetings in headquarters of the Army.
What was his reputation then?
He's really a very serious officer that is really, he has a commitment to really fight against the communists or the CPPNPA.
General Anyo, he has been a fugitive since 2011. We're not saying na laxitibo rin ang AFP dahil ang tagal. Pero can you describe, gaano ba siya katinig para laging mga nakailang attempt, nakailang failure kayo bago niyo siya finally nahuli today?
Well, unlike kasi sa mga terrorist organization or CPPNPA that it kailangan nila mag-communicate with each other in order to run the organization. Yun yung mga ibang witnesses na pwede na exploit, na titrace siya. They have to move from one place to another to meet somebody, to get instruction, to give assignment to some people. But Gerald Palparan is not like that. He can hide inside the house for days without even getting sunshine or, you know, ganun siya katsaga. He can be very patient not to contact, communicate his family. So, ganun siya katsaga. So, mahirap talaga na
Have you received information that there are threats to the family of General Palparan?
There were some threats that directed against Gerald Palparan, threats coming from the NPA.
How about yung family? Immediate family?
No, we don't monitor anything. But the NPA really was trying to find Gerald Palparan to...
General, before sa Santa Mesa, Maynila, na discover si Palparan, ano yung prior place na pinagtaguan niya? In Metro Manila ba o sa nearby provinces?
Sa nearby provinces, andyan yung Bataan, Pampanga, Nueva Ecija. He was even seen sometime in Cagayan de Oro, but that was last year.
Sir, gaano katagal yung mga itong mabanggit mga places, sir? Normally, how long does he stay from one place to another? Pag may nakikita na bang mga operatives sa kasya
ko? Yeah, sa tingin ko ganun eh. He's very aware of the surrounding. Kapag kami nakita siyang something, mga changes or mga suspicious, ano, suddenly, lumilipat na siya ng, ano, ng tirahan niya.
Is that considered some threat from NPA?
Sa kanya? He has been a subject of manhunt by the NPA even when he was still at the military service. In three occasions, the NPA, especially the SOG, the Communist NPA SOG, Special Operation Group, got close to him. But fortunately, he was saved because he has his security and he also changing his patterns.
Sir, pwede pong pa-describe yung bahay ni Grace? Ano, is it boarding house or...
It's an old house. It's an old house na ang mga bintana niya yung parang kapis pa.
Was it open, sir? Or ano, matura?
Hindi ako nakapunta doon. Mga operatives lang yung nag-describe sa akin. But there is, yung alam mo, may bakery sa ilalim, sa ibabaw ay lumang bahay. Typical sa, ano, sa...
Sir, saan yung bahay, sir?
Santa Mesa.
Teresa. Ano
Corner Teresa and Old Santa Mesa Street.
Sir? Since he was just alone, was he armed?
No, he's not armed. He was not armed. No.
So, niwala man siyang pang-depensa kahit sa NPA?
Yes, yes.
So, ano to, sir? Wanted siya sa NPA, wanted din siya sa batas natin. So, nag-uunahan ba kayo na makakosa kanya?
It's better nga na nahuli siya. Now, he's safe. He can also be given his spare of chance or his spare of sharing justice.
Sir, hindi sa minamaliit natin ang NPI, especially that the threat of General Palparan is that serious. Like, anong gaano tayo assured na secure siya sa NPI? Eh, si Colonel Mangkaw nga, nakatakas, hindi na malayan eh. Marami rin na rin mga history na nakatakas siya at napatay. Like, you know, considering the high, the level of threat of General Palparan, sir, how can we be so sure?
May mga initial coordination na kami ng NPI kung paano ma-reinforce yung custodial center nila doon. Depende sa mapag-agree ng mga heads natin, si director at si chief of staff, whether we are going to put additional uniformed troops there or whatever reinforcement that we will accord to the NBI.
Sir, sina Osorio dito nakakulong, pwede rin may kulong dito si General Palparan?
Sina Osorio sa Philippine Army sila nakakulong.
Pwede rin ba silang sa military facility si
Palparan? Depende pa rin doon sa court. He is no longer an active member of the military. Eh. Normally, yung active member ng military ang pwedeng i-custody.
Generally, yung Teresa for color, it's a depressed area. Yung lugar na yan?
Hindi naman sa depressed area, pero busy area. Mayroong terminal ng mga taxi doon, tsaka jeep.
Sir, yung pag-withdraw yun ng ano, minomonitor nyo rin ba yung bank transaction siya o nagkataon lang na chamban siyang nagbibigay?
Mahirap sagot ang tanong mo yun.
pero yung banko niya, sir,
basta nakita siya nang habang
nagbibigay. Nakapangalan pa rin sa kanya yung ATM niya?
Hindi nakapangalan sa kanya.
Hindi nakapangalan sa kanya?
Kanino pong pangalan?
Basta hindi nakapangalan sa kanya. Yes, we know, but hindi nakapangalan sa kanya.
So, alam na niya yung PIN?
Hindi naman
hindi nakapangalan. Si General.
Siguro.
Si
sinasabi po, ano, umalis si Jan Palparan ng bansa pero hindi naman natutoy. Saan pa talaga siya nagtago? Ito lang ba
sa... Dito lang siya sa ano. Sa within the country lang siya.
Pero lumayo ba siya ng Luzon or hindi?
There were some information before that he was cited in once in Cagayan de Oro and once in Leyte. But the rest dito na sana.
We'll have the last question. None, no. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir.
Pero hindi siya nagpunta doon sa mga area na malakas ang net. Ay, sir, sorry. One last. Sir, how true na yung mga area noon kung saan siya allegedly maraming napatay na NPA, nagkaroon ba ng or na-find out yung base na lumakas ulit daw ang NPA doon sa area?
Ay, mahirap sagutin niya. It requires a deep research study.
Sir, sir, last na lang. May reports din to na dito rin daw nagtago sometimes si General Palparan sa kampo mismo.
Ah, hindi. No. That's not true. He has never sought refuge in any military
camp. I saw him here.
When he was still in the active service. Thank you very much.
Sir, permission to get your number.